Hello, beautiful people, how are we today? Just one second, I have to talk to my Brazilian friends. Gente, se vocês quiserem legenda em português, clica nos três pontinhos no canto direito de cima da tela, vai em legendas, português e daí a legenda tá ativada. Tem legenda em todos os vídeos, tá? Espero que vocês gostem. Back to English, let's continue talking about emotions. I'll start this video by saying something that I really hope it gets stuck into your head so much that even when you die, you're not gonna forget about this. Your biggest talent plus your biggest trauma equals your purpose. I'm going to repeat that. Pay attention. Your biggest trauma plus your biggest talent equals your purpose. That means you have to get to know what is your biggest talent and you have to get to know what is your biggest trauma for you to live fully in your purpose. Okay? You have to get to know yourself. Otherwise, you cannot live a full life and a life that you're meant to live in this earth. You're not gonna be able to achieve anything towards your purpose if you don't get to know yourself, okay? I'll explain how this works with one example, a simple example. And I'm gonna use a relationship between a man and a woman because this is the kind of relationship that resonates with me, but you can use this for whatever relationship in your life. Love partners, housemates, workmates, mother-daughter relationship, father and daughter relationship, cousins, siblings, grandparent relationships, it doesn't matter. Whatever relationship you have in your life, this works for all of them, okay? So suppose there is a woman and there is a man and they've been dating for about 5 years, okay? In the beginning, it was all love and roses and poetry and flowers and beautiful things. And then something started to happen. This lady started to feel like something was a little bit off. And then she put this feeling away. And every time the guy acted a certain way, she would feel very disappointed, very scared, very angry. But then she would rationalize this emotion and, oh no, but he's gonna get better. Next time he's gonna be better. Next time he's not better. So 70% of the time is struggle. 30% of the time is good times. And this starts to get worse, okay? And the bad times start to be even bigger than that. Than the 70%, okay? We have something called the gut instinct, which is our intuition telling things to us. We're not taught how to listen to this voice, so because the voices in our mind speak too loud nowadays. So what happens is that the intuition works together with the ego and they transform the gut instinct into emotions because emotions speak louder than the gut instinct, okay? So she starts to feel bad emotions towards this relationship and she knows something is off. But then she rationalizes the emotion and she puts that away, okay? What happens is, first of all, when you put away your emotions, you're telling everybody but yourself that you don't care about yourself. Because when you put your emotions away, you're letting the universe know that for you, other people's opinions about how you should go on with your life are more important than what you think is better for yourself, okay? Because you're saying, oh, my emotions are telling me something. I will put these emotions aside because what my boyfriend is telling me is more important than my own emotions. And that's how you become submissive. People don't say that, but they can feel from a distance. People who don't trust themselves, and these are the people who are the target for abusive relationships of any kind, okay? You become submissive because you let someone else's opinion about your life be more important than your own opinion, okay? This is very major. When you leave your emotions aside and you become submissive, you stop your evolution. You stop what you came here to do in this earth, first of all. Second, you tell yourself that you don't care about yourself and you don't care about who you are and you care more about what other people tell you that you are. Therefore, your authenticity becomes further, like, it goes further and further away from who you are. And then there is a barrier between you and yourself. Okay, that's when you go into that limbo and that's when things go down and escalate real quick and you hit rock bottom real quick, okay? That's when you start to get too physical, stop listening to your spirituality and get too attached to your ego, okay? That's the limbo I was talking about in the past videos. This that I'm gonna say now is Very important, especially for people who have suicidal thoughts. And I'm going to talk about this very openly because I think we need to talk about this very openly. People think that when they suicide, the pain stops. It really doesn't. Because pain is the consequence of an unhealed trauma. Unhealed trauma comes in the form of energy and you make it physical. Therefore, this energy is living inside your spiritual body, not your physical body. So when you kill yourself, you kill the consequence. You don't kill the cause. And you go away from Earth with your spiritual body, which is where all the energy is concentrated. So you take the pain with you. It's ridiculously obvious, isn't it? You take the pain with you, so it doesn't matter. You think you're gonna kill yourself and you're gonna get rid of the pain. No, you're gonna get rid of the symptoms caused by pain. Pain is gonna go directly with you. And that's the problem. And then you're gonna bring this baggage even stronger the next time you reincarnate, okay? So this is gonna be carried by you until you have the courage to look inside, okay? And I'll finish this video with something very basic and very simple, but it's very true. RuPaul, the Queen of Drag, says, if you don't love yourself, how the hell are you gonna love somebody else? I believe in this very deeply. If people don't love themselves enough, how the hell are they gonna love somebody else? So if you see someone giving more advice in your life than they actually take their own advice in their lives, that means that they are scared of looking inside themselves just as much as you are. So that means that they don't love themselves completely. So how the hell are they gonna know better than you what to do with your life? Think about that, because that's very true. There are no better people. People are not above each other. There's people who have the courage to look inside themselves and there's people who don't have that courage. Be the one that has the courage. And remember, if someone else is not looking inside themselves and is telling you something about your life, probably this is not good advice, okay? I hope that helps you. And remember, if you don't love yourself, how the hell are you gonna love somebody else? Work on yourself, because otherwise love is not gonna find you, okay? I love you, and I hope we help the world a little more.